He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, for today's problem, we're going to be looking at an acid-base reaction. So we have two reactants. We have a carboxylic acid and we have ammonia. And what we wanted to do is, first of all, draw the products of the acid-base reaction. Number two, label everything as acid-base, conjugate acid, and conjugate base. And then lastly, we want to be able to state the preferred direction of the equilibrium. One direction is going to dominate over the other due to the pKa's of the acid and the conjugate acid, and we want to be able to select from that. Okay, so given that this is a carboxylic acid, that's a dead giveaway that that is going to behave as the acid, and then we know that therefore ammonia is going to act as the base. So remember, a Bronsted-Lowry acid is always donating a proton, and a Bronsted-Lowry base is always accepting a proton. This carboxyl proton is pretty acidic, it's pKa around 5. That is because the conjugate base is the carboxylate anion, that is resonance stabilized, that anion can move throughout this portion of the molecule. So that's going to be the acid, pKa around 5. Ammonia is going to be the base, this lone pair on the nitrogen can accommodate that proton. So that means what results is here, that's the carboxylate anion that we talked about, and that is resonance stabilized. Because of the resonance stabilization, remember that acid strength corresponds to the stability of the conjugate base. So because this conjugate base is quite stable due to the resonance stabilization, that means the carboxylic acid is relatively acidic. So that's going to be pKa around 5. So if ammonia went ahead and got that proton from the carboxylic acid, that is now going to generate the conjugate acid, NH4+, or the ammonium ion. And so ammonium has a pKa of around 9. So first of all, we're understanding that this is acid-base. The acid becomes the conjugate base, and the base becomes the conjugate acid. So these are the pairs here. Base becomes the conjugate acid. So hopefully we have labeled all of those correctly and got the correct products. And then the second thing we want to do is be able to predict the direction of the equilibrium. Now when you have an acid-base equilibrium like this, it is always going to favor the side that has the weaker acid-base pair. Because remember that when we're looking at acid strength, the stronger an acid is, the greater the tendency it has to get rid of its proton. The weaker it is, the less likely it is to get rid of its proton. So if we're comparing an acid with pKa 5 and an acid with pKa 9, the stronger acid gets rid of its proton better than the weaker one. So that means that we're going to favor this side, because it is the side with the weaker acid. It has less of a tendency to give up its proton than the stronger acid. So that means that most of the reaction mixture will resemble this side. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.